Amber, and I'm back with another video. Welcome to the Amber Alert channel. If you're new here and if you are part of the gang, welcome back. Thank you for tuning back into another video. So today's video, as you see in the title, is about the ending of my breastfeeding journey. As you know, if you've been on my channel for a little bit, I have a baby. He is currently 13 months. I know I promised the 13 month update. I'm gonna do the 13 month update. Probably gonna just record that video with this video. But my breastfeeding journey did come to an end about 2.5 to 3 months ago. So I pretty much stopped breastfeeding between 10 and 11 months for Jaden. In this video, I'm just gonna explain why I did and give a few tips for those mamas who are trying to get their baby to stop latching on to your boobs when they are hungry, of course. So to stay tuned for this video if you need tips and tricks on how to get your baby off of your breasts. Okay, so in terms of my breastfeeding journey, as you guys know, like, I really did enjoy it for the most part. Of course, it was hard at first, but I really did enjoy my breastfeeding journey. I actually was sad when it came like towards the end, because I don't feel like I was actually 100% ready to stop breastfeeding. But I don't know, a few circumstances happened that just made it make sense for me to stop at that moment. So the first thing that happened was my menstrual cycle came back. Obviously, I did not have my menstrual for about 10 months. It came back like right around the 11 month mark. And I feel like, no, it came back around the 10 month mark when Jaden was about 10 months. And I feel like as soon as it came back, like, my milk dipped drastically, and I was so nervous. Like, I was sad, you know, I was upset because I was like wondering, is he getting what he's supposed to be getting? Like, how do I know? Blah, blah, blah. I just noticed, like, even when I would pump, it was not the same amount that it usually would be during that, like, few days of my period. And I was like, what do I do? Like, you know, I initially did not start Jaden on solids. Like, it took a little bit longer. I didn't do the typical 6 months of solids. I started him on solids like 8-9 months. So he was still getting into like eating other things. So I was just like, I don't know like what to do. Like, you know, I don't know if he's getting what he's supposed to be getting nutrient wise and stuff like that. So it made it very hard for me though, breastfeeding when my menstrual cycle came back. Then when it came the next month, like the 11 month mark, that's when I noticed I really think I should just, you know, stop breastfeeding. The second thing that happened is, like, Jaden, he was super dependent on the breast for everything. And when I say that, I mean, like, for his naps, like, he would not go to sleep without the breast in his mouth, even if he was not hungry or anything like that. Like, he would not be able to sleep without me being there. And obviously, like, that plays a big role on you as a mom, mentally and emotionally, because it's like you don't even feel like you could leave your baby with anyone or do anything for yourself sometimes, because it's like he's gonna be miserable without me. Like, you know, if he's not on my breast, how's he gonna sleep? He's not gonna be like good without me, you know. That was it. And I feel like I also had planned a trip for AJ's birthday. We went to Antigua, and, you know, so Jaden was home with his grandparents for the weekend. At that point, like, once we were already away for a few days and Jaden was okay and he took like the bottle and stuff from them, like, it just made sense, like, when I come back to not put him back on the breast, because he already got used to like being on the bottle for those few days. So it was just like that was the perfect opportunity to wean him off and like not even go back to the breast. The last reason why I really stopped breastfeeding is because Jaden got his teeth. So Jaden got like his first 1 or 2 teeth at around 8 months, and I was still holding on, like, you know, but he would like bite down on my breast sometimes and things like that, and it was so painful. I was just like, oh my God. And then he started getting more teeth, and I was like, I can't, like, I cannot do it. Like, because when he would be drinking, it would be fine, but then when he would be done, he would just like bite down or like be playing around with the breast and stuff like that. And I was just like, I can't take this. Like, it was so painful. So that was the final straw for me. I was just like, I'm absolutely done breastfeeding. So now let's get into a few tips for weaning your baby off the breast. So for me, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. As I said, I did plan a trip to Antigua. So it was not hard because when I came back, even though when I did come back from the trip, like he was like still wanting to get on the breast, but he was already so used to the bottle for like those 4 to 5 days we were gone that it was a bit easier for him because it was like, you know, he already knew what was going on. And so when I came back, like I did try to put him on the breast as minimal as possible. So my journey was not that hard compared to a lot of people that I know. I'm still gonna share with you guys a few tips. So the first thing, I think I discussed this in one of my previous baby videos, but Jaden, when he was really small, like a few days old, there was a little issue. They thought basically that he had an allergy to my breast milk in his first few days of life. So because he had like a bloody bowel movement, they wanted me to stop breastfeeding. So for like the first 2 days after I got home from the hospital and that happened, we had to put him on a bottle. So he was on bottles, and then like we noticed it wasn't the breast milk that caused that. So then I started breastfeeding again, but he had already like gotten used to the bottles. So then it made it easier because when I went back to work and stuff, I would pump, or like even when Jaden would go to his grandparents' house or something, I would just pump and leave the bottles for him, and then he would just drink from a bottle. Like he never had any issue taking a bottle, like or knowing the difference between the bottle and the breast, like whatever you gave him, he was okay with as long as he was getting fed. So that was the first thing. Like I would recommend, if you are comfortable, introducing a bottle at an earlier age so that when it is time to wean, it's not like, you know, your baby's not taking a bottle, like, you know, they don't know how to use a bottle or anything like that. Like Jaden was really good. Like as I said, his first few days of life, I had to give him a bottle for 2 days. And he literally was fine. And then after that, it was easier for me to like go to the supermarket and things like that, or when I went back to work, because we already knew like he would be comfortable taking a bottle. The second tip is, and this should have honestly been my first tip, but the second tip I have is make sure you are ready. So if you are not ready and you're still like very emotionally attached to your baby in terms of like feeding him from your own body, it's gonna be very hard. I feel like for me, it was an emotional experience because that bond like is so strong. Like when you know that you're able to provide something for your baby that no one else can. I literally can feed my son from my own breasts and no one else around me can do that for him. That's such a strong bond. And like, you know, it's hard to let that go because now it's like, okay, like he doesn't need me for that anymore, you know? So you start thinking like those type of thoughts. And you know, we already are very emotional postpartum. Make sure that it's on your own time and that you are completely ready to let go of the breastfeeding experience, because if not, you might feel very guilty, you might feel very emotional. I don't know. Don't listen to other people. Like other people's recommendations are not your life. Like what people think, what people say, what on their timeline is not what you should listen to. And I say this because like at one point I would be at work and people would be like, you're still breastfeeding? Some people say, oh yeah, you gotta keep breastfeeding. Or some people say, no, you don't need to be breastfeeding, like you need to stop, blah blah. Or like, you know, just venting to people, I'll be like, you know, I'm so tired, like I was up till whatever time, and then Jaden woke up for the breast at this time, and they're like, oh no, you need to get Jaden off the breast, blah, blah. You know, it's discouraging listening to other people. So, and I mentioned this in one of my breastfeeding tip videos, just make sure that you pave your own way and you do not listen to what other people say. You are a new mother, a great mother, and what you feel like you should do is what you should do. Listen to your own mommy instincts and make your own journey for you and your baby. Second tip that I have for weaning your baby off the breast, well, now I guess this is technically the third, but make sure that you gradually decrease your feeds. So if your baby right now feeds 4, 5, 6 times a day, then the next day you might go to 4, and then you might do 4 for a few days, and then you might go to 2, and then you might do 2 for a few days, and then you might only do the bedtime feed and then like do that for a little bit and then gradually just wean the baby off of that. That way it's not like cold turkey, unless you want to do cold turkey. Because I feel like it was weird because I went to Antigua, so I did kind of do cold turkey. Like I left a lot of milk for him and then he was drinking from the bottle for 4 to 5 days. But then when I came back, it was like he just, as soon as I landed and like saw him, he was like reaching for my breast again. So then I like kind of got him back on the breast by accident, just because I was so exhausted. So like then I was doing like 2 feeds, the morning and the eat and the night. And then I cut out the first one and I only was doing the night. And then I started just doing no feeds and just giving him the bottle whenever. Do it gradually if you want. Make sure that you just start cutting the feeds slowly. Once you cut a feed, do not go back to it. That's the main thing, because now you're going to confuse your baby. So if for a few days you were not doing that morning feed, next week don't start that morning feed again, because now your baby already got used to not doing the morning feed and now you're gonna have to start the whole process over. This is goes back to what I say, like make sure you're 100% ready, because if you're not, then it's gonna be hard for you to like do it, and then the baby's gonna reach for it and you're not gonna have that strong willpower to like say no or not, you know, not provide that for your baby. So that goes back to that, but make sure you do not go back to the feeds when you already finish getting rid of it. The next tip I have is do not offer the breast. So a lot of times the baby might reach for the breast, but if the baby does not reach for the breast, do not offer it. And this also goes back to being ready, because if you're not ready, you want your baby to be dependent. So you're like, look baby, look at my breast, baby. Like, you know, if the baby is playing, if the baby's doing whatever they're doing, and it's usually the time that they might be on the breast, but they're completely not paying attention to you, do not offer it. You leave them alone, you start offering them whatever food or other bottles or other things. Do not offer the breast if they are not looking for it. Another tip for weaning is use distractions. So make sure you are engaging with your baby in other ways other than just breastfeeding. Reading to the baby, playing with the baby on the floor, crawling around, acting like a monster, whatever it is. And this is gonna help you, because that way your baby is not only knowing his mother as a milk machine, but now he's knowing you as like a playful person, someone who will do this with me and that with me. So that way, when they see you, it's not all about milk. I feel like at one point in my breastfeeding journey, every time Jaden saw me, it was just for breasts. Like it was just tugging at my shirt or something. Then I had to start doing other things with him so that he knows like, mama can do this too. I'm very versatile, okay? It's not all about milk, baby. So that is my other tip. Like make sure your baby can associate other things with you. Use your distractions wisely and just grow with your baby in other ways. The next and last tip that I have, I would say like, and obviously if this is feasible for you, have someone else help you feed the baby in the nighttime. And I say this because a lot of times, like if the baby smells you or is near you, then they're gonna want the breast. But if you have someone else and they have the bottle and they can feed the baby, then I would definitely recommend that you allow someone else to take over in certain instances so that the baby's not smelling you and near you all the time. And that is definitely helpful for weaning your baby. Okay guys, so I hope this video was super helpful for you mamas who are trying to wean your baby off the breast. As I said, make sure you are completely ready and you are an amazing mother, whether you breastfeed or not. So always keep that in mind. As long as your baby is getting fed, then that's all that matters. Bye mamas, thank you for tuning in, and I hope to see you guys again in my next video. Mwah.